Hello and welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to look at how you can publish your Chrome extensions onto the Chrome Web Store. So there's a few things that you need to bear in mind when you're publishing your Chrome extensions, particularly if this is the first extension that you've made. So I'm going to jump into my screen now. As you can see, I'm on the developer dashboard. So all my current extensions I've got archived over here, but otherwise your extensions would appear in a list over here. When you're ready to add your extensions, you just need to click New Item over here and then select a zip file of your folder that your extension's in with all the files zipped up. So I've got an example extension I've put together just to go through this. So if I go over to my code editor now, you can see a very basic manifest file that's sort of like a typical extension that you can expect. So we have our name, our description, the version number, and permissions. After this, we've got our icons, so you need to make sure that you're including all of your icons in here. You can use the same image for each of the different sizes, but you have to have this in here, otherwise they'll reject your extension when you try to upload it. You can also put your browser action icon in here. Now this is what appears up in the corner here in the extension tray. And then underneath, we've also got a content script. So this is if your extension is actually changing the display of a web page. And then you have to set in the web store why you need these permissions as well. So for example, here, I've got this domain.com. I'll show you in a moment what you actually need to put in for this when you upload it onto the web store. Okay, so just here is my folder that my extension is in. So as you can see here, here's all the different code for my extension. Now all I need to do is just turn this into a zip file. So just compress it like this. And then now we can go to the web store again and upload this. So I'll go back to Chrome, click on New Item, browse for your extension zip you just created. So here's mine, select it. It will then upload, and then it will look through the manifest and find out all of the settings that we just created a moment ago. So as you can see, there's the title, the description. So you then can go ahead and select a category, a language, and all of these other information. So you can fill this out. This one's quite easy to do. But the thing that you need to take a close look at is privacy. So this has changed a lot in recent updates to the web store. So you have to first set a single purpose description for your extension. So if this was an extension for Gmail, for example, if it added a button so you could schedule an email, you have to clearly state that this extension runs on gmail.com and adds a button for people to schedule emails. So that helps them quickly understand why you need the permissions that you're asking for and what your extension actually does. So as I mentioned a moment ago, I added extra permissions in here. So if we look at our manifest, you can see I've added active tab and tabs. So for every permission that you request, you need to say why you actually need this. So a really good thing to do is if you don't actually need those permissions, remove them, because it saves you so much time, because each of these permissions will have to be reviewed separately, so it can make it much longer for your extension to be approved in the first place. So if you don't need those permissions, remove them. And as I mentioned, you have to put it again for each of these. And then it asks you if you're using any remote code. So this is things if you're including any JavaScript files or other types of scripts that aren't in your folder. So if you're calling in jQuery, for example, externally, you would need to state that in here and why you need to use that. Otherwise, make sure you're including it in the folder. So next, you have to say exactly what data you're collecting from your users, and then you have to sort of explicitly say that you're not going to sell this on or transfer it in any way. So for example, let's say I wanted to get the user's location so I could personalize this to show the weather near them, for example. I would need to state this, and then I'd need to make sure that I'm not selling this on. So you have to make sure that all of this is in line with Google's policies. So once you've set all of these things, you'll be ready to save your draft and get your app ready to be reviewed. But you first need to make sure that you fill out everything on the store listing page. As we mentioned, the description, you want to try and be as detailed as possible. So this is where you're actually selling your extension to people browsing on the store rather than to Google. So that's more on the privacy page. So this is where you want to outline exactly what your extension does, the benefits from it, why someone should use it, and a little bit about the story of why you created it as well. That can really help to increase the amount of times your extension will be installed. You need to add in your store icon, at least one screenshot, and then you can add more images down here. Now these help if your extension is going to get featured on the web store. You need to have these uploaded as well, so make sure to look at that if you want to have your extension featured. And then you need to add in a URL, so this is somewhere you can link through to a website or a blog post about why you built your extension. And you can add a Google Analytics ID in here as well, so you can get more detailed information about who is using your extension, the conversion rates and things like that. And finally, there's the pricing and distribution section here. Now recently, Google removed the option to take payments through the web store. So if you want to charge for your extension, you can do this manually through things like Stripe. And there's a video on my channel about how you can do that and this change that they made. I'll put a link in the description to that. But otherwise, here you can just set where your extension should be available. So which countries, which regions, and if it's going to be public on the extension store or if you want it to be unlisted. So similar to if you're publishing a video on YouTube, for example, you can choose what level of permissions people can actually access your extension. So that is everything that you need to do to get your extension ready to be published on the web store. So once you've finished filling in all this information, you just click Save Draft over here. And then if you filled in all your information, so you can see here, the Submit for Review button is grayed out at the minute. If that is, you can see exactly why that is. So you can see I haven't filled in all the information yet. But once you've filled that in, you can just click Submit for Review. And then there'll be a box in there where it can automatically be published once it's reviewed. If you want to take a look at it first before it's published, you can untick that box. But otherwise, just go ahead and tick that box, click OK, and then it'll automatically be published once they've finished reviewing your extension. So thanks for watching this video. If you've got any questions on anything we've covered during this video, just drop a comment and I'll try and get back to you as soon as possible. But otherwise, thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want to find out more about how to create Chrome extensions with more videos like this.